Hi everybody, welcome to our virtual yoga class tonight. My name is Melissa Bryan and I normally teach Candlelight Yoga here at the Angel Wing with you guys here, but we are making these videos so that you guys can continue your practice at home. So you don't need any props for this class, but if you have something to sit on, maybe it's a few pillows or a blanket folded up, that can be nice to start. We're just gonna start in a seated position, cross-legged, anything that's comfortable for you. And use this as an opportunity to find some grounding. You can soften your gaze or close your eyes, wiggle around, get all your fidgets out until you find stillness. Root your seat into whatever you're sitting on. And the more that you can find stability and root into the ground, the more you can lift up through your sternum and your chest. Drop your shoulders. Notice if your head is jutting out or pushed back and try to find neutral. And elongate and find space in your spine. Notice the shift from coming into this practice from our crazy world. Everything may seem a little bit out of balance right now, a little bit unusual, scary, and even anxiety-inducing. But although all of those things may be true, it's also a great time for gratitude and to find a silver lining in all of this, whatever that may be for you. And to keep some sense of normalcy and routine in a way that is safe and comfortable for you. Place one hand on your chest and one hand on your belly and deepen your inhales and exhales. Noticing that as you inhale, your air pushes into your hands, and as you exhale, it pushes away. Note that as you inhale, you're inhaling in a 360 degree way through your sides and through your back. As you exhale, it gently releases. Notice how your breath feels today. And try to open up your airways so it's a nice, smooth, easy breath, but each breath feels like new, fresh air. Like it's the first day at a beach house and you open all the windows and all that fresh air is just naturally coming in and out. You can switch the cross of your legs for evenness as we continue to breathe. Blink your eyes open if they're closed. Place your hands on your thighs and we will start moving. So slowly come off of your prop, move it out of the way, and come to hands and knees. Place your palms right under your shoulders and your knees right under your hips. And as you inhale, drop your belly, open your chest, lift your gaze. And as you exhale, push the floor away, round your spine towards the ceiling. Inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat pose. Continue at the pace of your breath, inhaling as you open your chest and lift your hips, and exhaling as you round your spine, moving every single bone in your body, in your spine, paying attention to every single one. option to flip your wrists around so your fingers are pointing straight back towards your knees. Your thumbs are out to the side and continue your cat-cows. They might get smaller with this new restriction in your body, something that we're not quite used to. And flip your hands back to face forward. Walk your palms forward about a palm print. Tuck your toes and lift your hips up towards the sky for your first downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Plant your palms into the ground, all 10 of your knuckles into the ground. Lift through your arms and shoulders. Broaden your shoulder blades. Reach your hips up and back. If you need to maintain a bend in your knees, that's perfectly fine. On an inhale, reach your right leg up towards the sky for three-legged dog. As you exhale, pull your knee straight towards your nose in a plank and push it back out on an inhale. Exhale, bring your knee across your body, right knee to left elbow. Reach it back. And exhale this time, right knee, right elbow. One more time, kick it back. And this time, step your right foot straight between your hands for a lunge. Keep your back knee lifted. Plant your left hand into the ground and reach your right arm up. Aiming to stack your right shoulder right over your left shoulder. And lift your gaze up to your hand if that's possible. Don't forget to breathe. Drop your hand back down to the ground and step back into a downward facing dog. For a moment here, drop your head, shake it out. On an inhale, lift your left leg. And on an exhale, bring it straight to your nose. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, activating your core as you bring your leg across your body. Kick it back. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. Kick it back. And final core stability, bring your leg straight forward and foot lands between your hands. This time, plant your right hand into the ground. And reach your left hand and arm straight up to the sky. Don't forget about your back leg. Keep that knee lifted and active. Bring your left hand back down to the ground. Step back. Drop your knees for a moment, a little bit wide. Bring your toes to touch and sit back. For a child's pose. Bring your hands into a prayer position and then point your fingers up and straight back. A little bit of a tricep stretch here. To the ground, tuck your toes and lift back up for downward facing dog. This time on inhale, lift your left leg and bend your knee and open your hip and kick your heel to your butt so you can get an opening through that front hip and circle your leg around. This time, just step your leg straight forward and walk your hands along the right side of your mat until you come to a wide forward fold. Lift up for a second, find length in your spine, and fold over. Place your left hand onto your right shin and reach your right arm up towards the sky, twisting again. the more you can leverage this connection of your hand to your shin, the more you'll be able to twist. Bring your hand down to the ground. Drop here for a moment. Shake out your head. Bring your hands to your hips and stand up tall. Point your left toes straight forward, right toes in a little bit at a 45 degree angle. Bend your left knee deeply and reach your arms actively straight out to the side and gaze over your left middle finger. Activate your glutes so you're not sticking out your butt too much. And on inhale, straighten your legs, graze your right hand along your right leg, and open up for reverse triangle. Opening all throughout your left side body. Cartwheel your hands down to surround your left foot. Come into this low lunge. Step your right foot in about a foot so it can land flat, and then straighten both legs. So you might need to step your right foot in even more for pyramid pose. Your right toes can still remain at a little bit of an angle. Try to drop over that left leg. On an inhale, rise up, bend your knee, plant your hands to the ground, and coordinate so we meet back in a downward facing dog. Lift your right leg up to the ceiling and open up your hip. Bend your knee, make some circles, finding fluidity in this movement. Kick your legs straight back, find the neutral pelvis, and step your foot forward between your hands. This time, walk your hands around the left side of your mat and fold over. Reach your right hand to connect to your left shin and lift your left arm up towards the sky. Twisting is really great for digestion and cleansing. Bring your hands down to the ground. And I know that we're all probably eating more than usual right now because there's nothing else to do. Bring your hands to your hips and stand up tall. Point your right toes forward, left toes in, and find your warrior two, your Virabhadrasana two. Make sure that your knee tracks straight over, straight forward, the same line as your toes, but your knee is right above your ankle. Activate your glutes. Keep your torso straight, upright. On an inhale, straighten your legs, reach your right arm up, left arm along your back leg, finding this opening, and cartwheel your hands back down to the ground. Step your left foot in as much as you need to. Each side might be very different. Find a little length in your spine and then fold over your right leg. Notice if your right hip is trying to come forward, the more you reach your right hip back and your left hip forward, so you're starting to square your hips forward, the more stretch you get in the back of your right leg. Bend your right leg, plant your hands on the ground, and meet back in downward facing dog. We are going to go into a pigeon pose. So if you have a blanket, you can put that right in the middle of your mat. Meet back in downward facing dog. Reach your right leg up towards the sky and cross it across the mat. So your right foot lands on the left side and your shin is relatively parallel to the front of your mat. Your left leg will point straight back. If this already feels like too much for you, like a modified version, you can just bend that knee so both legs are bent and you're in this little mermaid position, and then you can fold over your legs that way. Find length in your spine first before you fold, and then hinge forward. Walk your fingers forward until you can fold over your leg. If you have a pillow or books you want to rest your forehead on, that can be very comforting. Notice where you have tension in this pose. In your hips, in your neck or jaw. And try to breathe your air into those areas. And try not to resist the pose. If it's too much, maybe you lift your torso a few inches. Find your sweet spot where you can really focus on releasing. What can you let go? What don't you need to worry about right now? You have a choice in letting it go. Walk your hands in, press into the floor so you can come back upright. Tuck your back toes and kick that right leg back again. Might feel good for a little bit of movement. Meet in downward facing dog. Lift your left leg, kick it forward, bring your left foot to the right side so your shin is relatively parallel. If your back leg is straight, try to make it so your knee is down on the ground and your knee shouldn't feel uncomfortable. So if it does, maybe try that modified version. Inhale, find length. Maybe push into the ground for a moment and then crawl your hands forward and fold. Just like any stretch, both sides could feel very different. So if they do, that's okay. We just want to give them both attention. Walk your hands in, sit upright, and tuck that back toe, swing your leg around. Just come to your knees for a moment, move your prop out of the way if you used one. And actually come to sit on the edge of your prop. Bring the soles of your feet to touch. Find a little diamond shape in your legs. And sit tall for a moment. Put your fingertips behind your hips and open your chest. Paddhakonasana. We fold over our legs. You can play around with the position here, so your feet don't need to be super close into you. Your feet can actually be in any position. Sometimes you get different kind of stretch depending on where your feet are. Play around with that. Don't forget to drop your head. Vertebra by vertebra, so your head is the last thing to lift. And now you can really move your prop out of the way. Come to your back. Bring your feet wide on your mat with your knees bent and lay down. Knock your knees together so they touch for a constructive rest. And place one palm on your chest, one on your belly. And notice your breath again here, just like we did at the beginning of class. You can always come back to your breath. You can always think about your breath. It's always there for you. And you'll probably always learn a little something when you tune into it. This pose is really good for the lower back because it creates space in your lower back. So feel free to stay here for longer. Otherwise, bring your knees into your chest and cup your knees with your hands and just circle around a little bit. Roll out your lower back in each direction. Maybe your knees go in opposite circles so you can open and close. Open up your inner thighs a little bit. Go both directions. Then bring your knees to your chest, tuck in your chin, rock and roll along your spine until you can sit upright again. Come to a cross-legged position. Bring your hands to your thighs. Sit tall. Reach the crown of your head straight up and drop your shoulders. Acknowledging what you might have experienced today. You can always come back to your yoga practice, no matter what's happening in the world or wherever you are. There's always an opportunity to find peace and look within. Bring your hands to your heart, drop your chin. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me in my yoga practice tonight and sharing it with all of you. Thank you so much for coming to the Angel Wing page. We hope to see you all soon. Thank you so much.